Entertainment and VIP news.
Here we go.
Showtime. Everything that's entertainment. This is VIP.
VIP with Lina.
Hi, Dino.
Hi, how are we?
I'm good, how are you?
Very good, thank you, yes.
I'm excited about Brookside Close.
Are you?
Yeah.
Why?
£735,000.
Somebody's got a bargain there,
bargain.
I'm telling you.
Yeah. Was it 13 houses?
13 houses in all, yes, a job lot. I went under the hammer today, this morning, and that's what they went for.
How's it looking? Was it still sort of overgrown? Because it hasn't been used for years now.
It's laying empty since it was sold off. I know that a property developer had it for a while and was making certain improvements and putting walls back up that have been knocked down and that sort of thing. But yeah, looking a bit, I've got one of my regular listeners often pops down there and sends me photographs that we put on the webpage, and it looks a bit forlorn. It needs a bit of TLC.
A bit of love and attention.
Yeah.
Do you have any sort of fond memories about getting up to naughty stuff on the Close? You can tell me. It's okay. No one else will hear.
Getting up to naughty stuff? Yeah, do you suggest it, Lena?
No, I don't know.
Jimmy and Sinbad getting up to naughty. Beggars belief, that one. I've very happy memories of Brookside Close, of course I have. That's, you know, all started there for me all those years ago. When did I first join? I think 1985. Don't think you were born then, were you?
I was six.
Were you a babby? Were you a fan of Brookside?
I sort of watched it intermittently, but, you know, who can forget the massive storylines?
Yeah, indeed.
Massive.
Yeah. First lesbian kiss,
body under the patio.
Body under the patio. And, you know, people used to accuse us of being, you know, sensationalist just for the sake of it. But when that storyline came out about the body going under the patio, of course, it was Trevor Jordash. Yes. And you know who discovered that body, don't you?
Was it you?
It was Jimmy's dog, Cracker. Digging in the back, yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
See,
yeah. Yeah, Jimmy's dog. Jimmy was there as well. But, when that story broke on the programme, and everybody was going, this is ridiculous, how ridiculous, you know, they're just doing that just to be sensational. And, of course, about 6 weeks later, a real body was found under a patio.
Oh, no, that's just shocking, isn't it?
So
but also, when you think about things like that then, and you look at some of the storylines on our soaps now, you think, girl, how times have changed.
I don't really watch the soaps these days, do you? Are you a fan?
Well, one that's been causing a bit of a furore was the EastEnders sort of paedophile storyline that came out just last week.
Yeah.
And, you know, it was pretty explosive and quite close to the edge on that one.
We did it first on Brookside.
Been there, done that.
Done that.
So I thought we should, you know, say a little nod to the fact that your old home was sold.
Apparently, it has been bought by somebody locally.
Mm.
And I think that bodes well, really. I mean, there was a suggestion that, you know, maybe the big boys might move in and bulldoze it, and there's a piece of television history raised to the ground, as it were. So hopefully that bodes well. If we get any news on that, we'll bring it to you.
They might turn into a big fairground attraction.
They might do, yeah. Well, it would make a great tourist attraction. Lots of people always say to me, you know, especially when the show was on, can we come and visit the Close, you know? And I say, well, you can't really, because it's a working set. But obviously your friends and family could come and have a look around, and everybody was always fascinated by it.
It would be, for me, it would be like Ramsey Street or Albert Square, it's exactly the same, you know, just iconic Coronation Street, exactly.
As I said, it's a part of television history. You can't change that, you know, it was on the screen for 21 years, immensely popular, people still stop me in the street and talk about it even today, and it's been off air for 5 years.
I know, how long, I know, it's insane. Moving on from that happy story to Madonna and Guy Ritchie.
Oh, what are they up
to? Back in the news.